I'm gonna edit this part out too. But I'm gonna keep it in, who knows. I do that sometimes. Okay, so ready?
Yeah.
You can't really see me unless I do this. Okay, so I'm gonna do that.
Well, do you wanna push it up a little bit?
No, it'll be fine. Cause like the focus is like on the scenery in you.
Okay.
Okay. So, 1, 2, 3. Hey guys, Lady Indigo here with a guest. And we're gonna do things a little different today. This is...
I'm Brandon from BC Art.
And I'll send a link probably in the middle, because it looks nice when you put stuff in the middle.
Yeah.
And
right here.
Yeah, like in this area. Okay. That clap, it's gone. So basically what we're gonna be doing is a tea leaf reading. And it's... I wanna explain what a tea leaf reading is. A tea leaf reading is where you make tea, and you can use this with a tea bag. It doesn't always have to be loose leaf tea. You let it steep, you let it brew, whatever you say, and then you take the tea bag out, and then you let the person who you're going to give a reading drink it. Now, there's many methods to be doing this. The method I'm going to be using is an 11-month general reading. Where you use the handle as a guide, being the present, and then clockwise going out until you reach back to the handle. And it goes roughly about an inch, depending on how big your cup is. But
is
yeah.
Is that why we have a bigger cup?
Yeah, you need like a big round cup for this so that the leaves, or yeah, the little leaves could like be clumped up in certain ways. Because it's kind of like looking up into the sky and reading clouds.
Constellations? Or
no, like clouds. Like, you know when like you're a kid, you're just woken up and you see clouds, like, oh, that one looks like a duck. And someone's like, it looks like a rabbit.
They just form shapes.
Yeah, they form shapes, and depending on what you think they are, then we'll go through a thing to look up what it is. And there'll probably be like a cut there somewhere, so we could actually look up what you find. But yeah, that's what a tea leaf reading is, and also simultaneously interview. So I'm going to be keeping an eye on this because you're supposed to have a little bit of liquid at the bottom because you're going
to
like...
Because I'm unsure where to stop, so yeah. She's going to keep an eye and make sure I don't drink too much.
Yeah, like you need a little bit of liquid for this at the end because you rip open the tea bag and then you swirl it. Like, you'll see it. It's happening. This is what's going on. So, Brandon.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't done this in a while. So, Brandon! I'm gonna cut that out. So, Brandon. what is your current spiritual path and or beliefs in terms of, like, spirituality stuff?
Well, overall, I guess I would consider myself a Methodist. But, there's just some things, as far as the Bible is concerned, I don't agree with. And some things, view-wise, I guess, that I don't agree with. So, I mean, like, for a big thing is stereotypes and, like, how, like, being gay and all that. That stuff I don't agree with, along with a bunch of other stuff as far as the Bible is concerned.
Mm-hmm.
But overall, I do believe in God. I do believe in the spirits around me because pretty much I do see spirits.
Oh, so, cool.
Not clearly as I see you, but
like you can feel them.
I feel them, I sense them, and like if I'm in a new house, I usually get some weird dreams from the residual energy within the home.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just stuff like that, and that's helped me know, like, and every once in a while I'll get a weird feeling, like you know there's someone there.
Mm-hmm.
And I can usually recognize the energy, so that's usually a family member, so.
Oh, okay. Well, that's nice. Hey, nephew and or niece and or relative, how goes it?
Well, it's like I'll be sitting on my bed and then, like, it's mainly I feel my aunt, because she had died last year.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And, yeah. And mainly it's like if I'll be sitting on my bed and then, like, out of nowhere, I'll get this rush of cold. Just sitting right beside me and like on me, and then it was like around me. So
like a feeling, like a tingling.
Mm-hmm.
For you, it's a cold.
For me, it's cold. Yeah. And it's my mom has the heat on all the time, so for me to get a rush of cold means there's something there.
Something going on. Something else.
But overall, that's kind of what I believe. I mean, I believe in pretty much everything, and everybody should have their own belief system. Like, I don't believe you should just go around and saying, you are not supposed to believe this, you're supposed to believe this.
Oh, like policing what people should believe.
Yeah.
Like, that's,
I think everybody should have their own belief system and should come into how they believe it in their own way.
Yeah. That's kind of what drew me into, like, my current path, because there was a branch called, like, eclectic, which means, like, a variety of things.
Mm-hmm.
Eclectic solitary practice, so you can practice alone. You don't have to be, like, in a group or anything. And, like, you can basically pick and choose, more or less, is what I got from gathering, like, from Tumblr and the internet and stuff like that. Because I was like, I want to get into this, but I didn't know there were that many branches.
Yeah. Well, my family was originally Catholic, and then my aunt found the Methodist church that we go... No, we don't go to it now anymore, but...
That you went to at one point.
For specific reasons. Yeah. Well, there's reasons why we don't go.
Okay.
But, we went to this Methodist church. She went to the Methodist church, and then whenever me and my sister were with her, she would take us, and then once my mom moved back over here, we just pretty much always went together.
Oh.
And we pretty much just converted to Methodist. And, like, I just hear so many horror stories about Catholics. And I don't want to be generalized. I don't like to generalize something, but just how they believe and how they just go so much by the Bible, it almost scares me.
Oh, yeah. Like, some of them could be really hardcore. I should know. I used to be Catholic.
Okay.
Yeah. And, like, a good part of my family's, like, one part of the family's
Catholic. Well, that's the thing.
Catholic.
I don't judge by religion.
Yeah.
At all. Like I just said, everyone should have their own belief system. Mm-hmm. I'm not here to take your belief system away from you.
Oh, yeah. No. Just here to chill and float around.
Yeah. Because that's what bothers me with a lot of people. A lot of people will just go, like, oh, no, you're wrong. You need to believe in this, or this needs to be like this, and I'm like,
oh yeah,
no, not necessarily. I mean, we deserve to explore our own journeys and understand ourselves,
of course.
So
yeah, cool. Let's see. No, like, well, just don't take big gulps and you'll be fine. How's it taste?
It's okay.
Okay. Well, it's like
I'm not a huge tea drinker, so.
Oh, okay. So,
it's okay.
You just said you're like Methodist to a point, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah. And, like, what?
Well,
what?
I guess overall, I'm not really in a religion, in a sense, just because of how my belief system works. I guess I don't read the Bible, so I don't know how that correlates with my religion or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But we do go to a Methodist church, so that's when I'm asked, that's what I say.
Okay. I get you. I was like that at one point, too. Like, oh yeah, I'm Catholic. Let's see, what was I gonna ask? It was... This happens in, like, so many other interviews, too. So, what made you feel comfortable enough to want a tea leaf reading?
Like I said, I'm a very open person to things.
Mm-hmm.
So, you're my friend, so to do anything with you would be fun. And, I like the supernatural for one thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I've had knowledge of some of this stuff, so it didn't really bother me at all to come into this and knowing. I knew that we were gonna probably do something along the lines of, like, a tea leaf reading or a reading of some sort.
Oh, okay.
So it doesn't surprise me. Like, I love the supernatural. I love knowing stuff about, like, witches and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And all sorts of stuff like that. So.
Okay. Yeah, my eyes are kind of bugging out. I can't really cut that out, but when I'm in conversation, it's
You're fine.
Yeah, like, I put on a couple of videos what's going on with me there, but... let's see. Yeah, like just take some more little sips. Like about like where you are right now, if you get to the halfway point of that, you'll be fine. Cause I don't want you to like have all this liquid and then potentially like drink the little tea leaves. do you have any questions for me about any of this stuff?
How did you become like what do you go as, Wiccan?
Wiccan, but I'm kind of like more into the point of like I practice witchcraft because
just practicing.
Yeah, just practicing, like yeah.
Well, how did you like find out about it? I'm sure you said this in other videos, but
like no problem. Let's see. It was when I was still Catholic. I went to confirmation, and they have a ceremony when like you're supposed to receive like this sacred anointed oil, and they put it like on your third eye chakra, like right there.
Yeah.
And like that was the only time I actually felt close to God. Yeah. Like, I felt, like, a presence, like, a very light but very powerful presence.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, wow, this is what they always were talking about. But then, like, right after that, everything went back to normal. Like, the services were services. It was like they didn't, like, they preached, but they didn't practice it outside of church. Like, the people in general. Because some of them were just jerks.
Yeah, that was kind of my problem that I viewed with a lot of people in church. Mm-hmm. Like, they would... Like, we would have communion and, or we would have whatever kind of service,
yeah.
But it just didn't,
like, click.
So, yeah. Yeah, so I totally understand what you're saying.
Yeah, like, that happened, and then, like, I felt kind of, like, not lost, but, like, wandering. So, I asked some of my friends, and one friend asked, like, have you ever heard of Wicca, or... He didn't say paganism right off the bat, because he knew I was Catholic at the time. But he's like, have you looked into Wicca? I'm like, you know what, I haven't. And then I looked up some stuff. It's like, oh, you can do all this. And it gives you all this leeway compared to, like, other mainstream religions. And, like, it started off, like, back in the 40s, technically, by this guy named Gardner, like, in England. And, like, he was into some occult stuff, and then, like, he also looked into, like, old pagan things, so it's, like, a mix of new and a mix of old. But, like, it takes from the old traditions, but it also, like, lets you put your own thoughts and your own path that you can take yourself, which is what, like, really appealed to me about it.
Yes, that's really good.
And then I just did some more research, grabbed some more reading material, and then, like, I was in the... They call it the broom closet, and that should be about good. They call it the broom closet, and when you're in the broom closet, you're into the witchy stuff or pagan stuff, but you don't want anybody else to know. Like, only, like, certain friends or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So...
Well, because I can see how many people would... would view it as something negative, just because society always has a way of thinking of certain things, like either Wicca or like other certain types of religion, I would say, as being like worshiping the devil and stuff like that.
Like, it's not mainstream.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I understand that, like I say, I have a different way of thinking. So I totally know that that's not the way it goes. There is always multiple ways of doing things. So
more than one way to skin a cat.
Well, I wouldn't skin a cat, but
well, yes. like it's a phrase. I wouldn't actually skin a cat, guys. I like animals. I mean, blood's gross.
Yes.
So now we're to the part where it's about right here, and now we're gonna actually bust open this and let the tea leaves, like, this is like a regular little tea bag thing that you get at a store, and we're gonna try to get most of it. Now, like, any reading requires the person who's gonna be read their energy, and basically you put in your energy by sipping on the tea. And I'm just gonna do a little thing.
So, like, every time I was sipping,
yeah,
I was putting energy into the...
Yeah, you were putting, like, a little bit of your energy signature onto the cup itself. Ah, oh, crap, it's dripping. Yeah.
Okay, that's cool.
Yeah. I think that's the most we can get right now. Oh, I gotta do something real quick. Sorry. You're alright. I haven't really done this in a while.
I don't want to do anything
wrong. No, you're fine. Don't worry about it. So, we're gonna go... This is gonna be from your perspective. Okay. This will be on your side. But, we're gonna just switch this once, twice, three times. Once, twice, three times. And then I'm gonna need you to do the same thing when there's, like, less liquid in there, except for without this, you're just gonna go like that three times.
Okay.
In a clockwise position. Okay, so just try to sip the last, and I think the best way you can do this is by putting your top lip on the thing of the cup, kind of clamping down, but letting enough room so you can...
So you're, like, actually sipping. You're
yeah.
not drinking.
Yeah, you're not like, ah, you're like, ah.
Yeah.
And until you feel comfortable, like try to get it as
yeah.
close to the bottom as you can, but like I said, don't try to drink the loose. Yeah, I actually got this cup at a, what's it called, it's a thrift shop, no, an antique shop, and I'm just like, I need a certain kind of cup, and then I found the saucer later in the store. It was pretty rad. Just a little more.
Yep. I'm almost there.
Yeah.
It's just I'm trying hard not to get the leaves.
Oh yeah, it's hard to perfect when like you're doing it for the first time. But yeah, like with tea leaf readings, there's no really, I haven't really found a book about it, and I've been looking, but the internet is one hell of a gateway.
Very helpful. There's so much information on the internet.
Mm-hmm. And there's a couple sites that I use to actually decipher for tea leaf readings. So we're gonna have like a cut from what he's seeing into what we interpret it to be. So yeah. Let's see, where are you? Just a little bit more.
Okay.
Just like to where the liquid is low enough to where the tea leaves have air coming onto them. We also have a little bit of incense going on to help with
yeah,
the energy.
It smells good. I don't have a sense of smell.
No. Alright, let's give it a look. Perfect! Okay, now I'm going to need you to put in your dominant hand, your hand through the loop. Like this.
Oh, okay.
Yes. And then put it facing towards you like that. Lift up the cup a little bit. Swirl it clockwise three times.
From my point of view?
From your point of view, yes. Okay. Yeah. So you're gonna have to do this really fast. What I'm gonna need you to do is, and I probably should get a paper towel for this. So what I'm gonna need you to do is quickly flip the cup upside down.
Okay.
That's why the saucer's there, but wait until I get this done.
Just to catch?
Yeah, so it could have like all the extra liquid off, and it'll start making the clumps. Just we'll count together, and then you'll flip it. One,
two,
three.
Hopefully that worked.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it did. Just flip it and put it on the saucer. And tap 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
Okay, and then flip it. Actual tea leaves would have worked better, but this will work.
Oh, we're doing the best that we got.
We're working with what we got, guys.
Yep.
All right.
And, you know, we can always try it again.
Yeah, sure. I haven't really worked that much with tea leaf readings.